Good morning. I am Raksha Jaiswal, and in today's session, we are going to learn what is calorific value, their types, and estimations. Calorific value is also called as heating value. The calorific value is the amount of heat liberated during complete combustion of unit quantity of fuel. The types of calorific value are: one is gross calorific value, which is also called as higher calorific value, and another is net calorific value, which is also called as lower calorific value. Gross calorific value is defined as the amount of heat liberated during complete combustion of unit quantity of fuel, and combustion products allowed to cool at 15 degrees Celsius or 60 degree Fahrenheit. Now, net calorific value, which is also called as lower calorific value, is defined as the amount of heat liberated during complete combustion of unit quantity of fuel, and combustion products allowed to escape. Estimation of calorific value. They are of two types. One is warmed and the another is boiled calorimeter. Now, what is bomb calorimeter? We are going to see their construction, their working. Bomb calorimeter. Bomb calorimeter is used to determine calorific value of solid and non-volatile liquid fuel. See the construction. Here we have the strong cylindrical bomb, which is made up of authentic steel and can withstand with high pressure of 50 atmosphere. The bomb has two gas tight screw cap and the pressure release valve. The bomb also has two electrodes. One is made up of solid stainless steel electrode and the another is made up of hollow tube electrode, which allows the oxygen inlet. The one electrode has O-ring for crucible. Now the bomb is placed in copper calorimeter, which includes the electrical stirrer and Batman thermometer. The copper calorimeter is surrounded by air jacket and the air jacket is surrounded by outer water jacket. Now the working of bomb calorimeter. How does it work? We take accurately weighed amount of fuel in the form of pellet in crucible. Platinum wire is stretched across the two electrode here. And one cotton thread is attached to the fuse wire and another is attached to the crucible in contact with the fuel. 10 to 15 ml of distilled water is taken in bomb, which absorbs the acid vapor during combustion. Now bomb is filled with the oxygen due to hollow electrode, which allows the oxygen inlet and the pressure up to 25 atmosphere. The bomb is put in copper calorimeter, which containing water, stirrer and thermometer, and calorimeter is placed properly. Electrical stirrer is started. During electrical stirrer is start and Batman thermometer is adjusted. After 5 minutes, temperature is noted. Both the electrodes are connected to the 6-volt battery and charge is ignited. Then temperature is continuously recorded till the temperature start decreasing at uniform rate. The maximum temperature is the final temperature. The electrical stirrer is stopped and bomb is removed from the copper calorimeter. After this process, the bomb is allowed to stand for half an hour. During this process, acid vapor settles down and the contents of the bombs are washed. And finally, we determine the nitric acid and sulfuric acid. Estimation of bomb calorimeter. We have some correction. They are as First is acid correction, second is fuse wire correction, third is cotton thread correction, and cooling correction. In acid correction, the nitrogen and sulfur present in fuel are converted to nitric acid and sulfuric acid, which is exothermic reaction. We have some reaction. One is S plus O2, which gives SO2. Second is 2SO2 plus O2 plus 2H2, which gives 2H2SO4. Third is 2N2 plus 2H2O, which gives 4HNO3. The heat liberated is not obtained in practical use, as SO2 and NO2 are escaped. So heat liberated in bomb formation of nitric acid and sulfuric acid are subtracted. Now we see the fuse wire correction. In fuse wire correction, the correction of fuse wire is done by subtracting heat liberated in calories due to combustion of fuse wire. Now we see the cotton thread correction. The correction of cotton thread is done by subtracting the heat liberated in calories due to combustion of cotton thread. And now lastly, we see the cooling correction. In a cooling correction, the time taken for water in calorimeter to cool from maximum temperature to room temperature is called cooling correction. This is all about bomb calorimeter. If you like the video, please subscribe. Thank you.